Welcome to this video. In this video, I am going to talk about denture utility. It's a part of Siesta tool and which is used to visualize charge density. So this is the overview of flags which are used for charge density analysis using denture. And when we run Siesta, after the run of Siesta, the following files will be formed: .pld file, .dim, .tm, .in, .wfsx, and then we will run that FTF file again using denture utility in this manner. Here, there should be the name of the FTF file, and after the run of denture, files will be formed whose extension is .q. So one file is .drho.q. It contains charge density difference information. Then rho.q, it contains charge density. Then rho.down.q contains charge density for downspin. Similarly, we are having another file rho.up.q. It contains charge density for upspin. Then a file rho.up-down.q, and this contains difference of charge density corresponding to up and downspin. And all these .q files visualized using two softwares or the two tools. One is XCrist and another is Vista. So let us try to run a test example of iron. So I already discussed iron in the earlier lectures, and here this is the FTF for iron bulk. And let me discuss the flags of this charge density. So here, these are the flags for denture. These are some flags which you have to use. Here I am using angstrom as a unit. Then after this, another. So you can see these flags, and then set accordingly. And after this, right, these are another thing. So this is the complete overview of this. Now what I will do, I run this Siesta for this. And let us have a look at denture utility. I explained denture utility in the earlier lectures also, and how to install that. Let us have a brief look at that. It is in the util, and util, go to the denture. And here denture contains docs, right? You can see this PDF, and it explains every flag. Means you have to compile this tech file, and after compilation you will get a PDF file, right? And in SRC, there is denture utility, right? So I copied this from here to from here denture to user local bin, so that from a previous you can copy, yeah, denture from here to user local and bin, so that from everywhere you can give command denture. So now it is installed. So if I look at all the out files, so one file is the .dim file, another is dm file, then these files should be there. You should check all these files. Then another file is pld file. There is another file .in file, and another file is wfsx file, right? So these files are needed as I discussed. So this is one file, this is another file, this is third file, this is fourth, and this is five. These five files are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. These five files should be there. So these are already there. So then what I will do, I will run denture dm you can again run the same FTF file using denture utility, and after some time this will be completed. Sometimes this denture utility will take a lot of time depending upon this block, that how much we are considering this x, this y and z, and how many number of points we are taking. If these points more than 30, say maybe 60 or 70 or 80, then it will take more time, right? It depends upon that. So it's running, it will take some time. So I already compiled it. So these are the files. Let us have a look at the Q files which are already formed. Right. So these are the files which are already there. So you can use XChristian to visualize every file. I will give you that how example of one file. Say I go to the file, then open structure, and in open structure go to the open Gaussian queue file. You go to here, say if I'm interested, say difference of charge density or simple say you can see this file also, or you can see another file, say rho.q file. Say I am selecting say rho.q file, so I open it. Then after opening, go to the tools, then data grid, then you go to click on OK, then you can set ISO value 0.02 or 0.05, whatever, right? So submit. and go to here, planes, apply to 1, 2, 3 planes. Yes, you can display color planes, display ISO lines, and display thermometer. Right, so that's what we are getting here, the charge density plots. You can also change ISO value. And here in ISO line, you can change the color from this to rainbow color or another color. And you can change even the scale, which gives you better results. You have to choose the scale accordingly. You can even reset all these things. In this manner, you can change color or anything according to your needs. So here, this is the scale. This will tell you the charge density. So here the charge density will be larger and charge density keep on decreasing, right? It's for linear scale. Here you can see the contours. See, this is that how you can look at. So similarly, you can visualize another files also using XCriston. Now I am going to talk about that how in Vista we will see this these files. So I open Vista. I already installed Vista on my system. So you can give a path. Yeah. Say, first of all, I am looking at this RHO.Q file. So it will gives you this. This is the charge density contours. Or you can reset the thing. So you can see this dot surface show model, or you can show sections or the show ISO surfaces, and right in this manner you can see, and you can even change the property of these, right? You can atoms, bonds, even you can change this ISO surface. Right, you can even change the color. You can reset the minimum and the maximum value from here. Similarly, you can see another file. Let us go to here again, open. So it is the DRHO file. So here you can see difference of charge density. Let us try to open another files also. Say this is RHO for up file. Similarly, you can see the difference of up and down. So this is up minus down charge density. So this is a brief review that how files or .q files can be visualized using XCriston and Vista. And I briefly told in lecture that how denture utility is used to plot the charge density. So thanks for watching this video.